Hello everyone. So students, now today I have taken a very good question. So now students, this particular type of question, it is based on series and it has been asked in exams many times. So I'll explain you that concept. Basically, I'll explain you the shortcut, right? How to solve such questions. So students, anybody wants to enroll for any of our courses, you can visit our website. www.quantifiers.in, and we also have a Facebook group for your preparation. Regular questions are also being posted here. You can join this group, guys. Link is given in the description. So students, now let us come to the question. Now see, this is the question which I was talking about. So basically it is a question based on series. So now students, see, the one method. Now I'm directly going to discuss the shortcut here, right? See, first of all, this particular type of question, it can be solved by taking a general term. Pehle hum general term nikalenge and then we can apply the summation formula and we can find the answer. But students, that is very time consuming. So I'll tell you a shortcut for this type of series. Now, first of all, students, let us understand the series, what I'm talking about. Now, the most important thing is, if you look at the series, it is just like an AP. Okay. First condition, it is just like an AP. You can see there is a difference of two everywhere. There is a difference of two everywhere. So first condition is that it should be like an AP. Second thing, guys, if you see in each of the terms, if you look at each of the terms, all of the terms, they have equal numbers. All of the terms have equal numbers. Har ek term mein teen number diye hue. So this series is very symmetric. I hope these two points are clear to everyone. It is just like an AP and in every term there are equal numbers. Now students, coming to the most important condition, that is the third condition. Please listen to me very carefully. This third condition is, see, whenever you look at a new term, it is starting with that number. It is starting with that number, which is the second number of the previous term, Now, for example, if you look at the third term is starting with 7. And what is 7, guys? 7 is the second number of the previous term. So basically, students, you can see each term is starting with that number, which is the second number of the previous term. That is all you need to remember. Okay, I hope this part is clear to everyone. Now, students, let us come to the shortcut here. First of all, students, you have to see what is the common difference, because it is like an AP. It is like an AP. So see the common difference. So I'll write it here. Common difference is 2. Okay. And now, students, if you see in each of the terms, how many numbers are there? In each of the term, how many numbers are there? There are 3 numbers. Okay, students. So I'm assuming it to be n. N is equal to 3. Okay, what is n, guys? N is the how many numbers are there in every term. So as there are 3 numbers in every term, so I've taken n is equal to 3. Now, students, let us come to the shortcut. So guys, directly now I'll tell you, how can you find the answer? Students, answer will be 1 divided by common difference. 1 divided by common difference, that is 2. Students, into n plus 1, into n plus 1. So n is equal to 3. So you have to take 3 plus 1. You have to take 3 plus 1. So this is the first part, guys. Now coming to the second part, you have to multiply this by, Now students, just ignore all the terms except the first and the last. Just ignore all the terms except the first and the last. So our focus should only be on the last term and the first term. Now students, what you have to do, if you look at the last term, in last term there are 3 numbers. In last term there are 3 numbers, 31, 33, 35. Students, in this term only, take one more term. Take one more term which comes after 35. Okay. Take one more term which comes after 35. So that will be 37. And similarly, guys, if you look at the first term, there are three numbers, 3 × 5 × 7. Now, students, here also you have to take one more number. You have to take one more number, but the number which will come before 3. But the number which will come before 3. So it will be 1 × 3 × 5 × 7. Okay, students. Now, students, you have to take difference of these two things. Difference of these two things. That's it, guys. So difference kitna ho jayega? 31 × 33 × 35 × 37. And you have to take difference. So minus of 1 × 3 × 5 × 7. That's it, guys. By this, you will directly get your answer. So I hope all of you have understood this. Now, those who haven't understood, see, I am taking a couple of more examples, which will give you a very good idea. Okay, now what I'll do is I'll take only two numbers at a time. Here we were taking three numbers in every term. Now I'll take only two numbers in every term. So this will give you a much better idea. So students, now I'm taking this as, let's say, 5 × 8 plus 8 × 11 plus 11 × 14. And students, so on, let's say we are going till 32 × 35. Now, first of all, let us check the conditions. I told you it will be like an AP. Yes, it is like an AP. There is a difference of 3. There is a difference of 3. So it is like an AP. And you can see in every term, there are equal numbers. In every term, there are two numbers. And students, the third condition, which I told you, which is the most important condition, students, the new term, every term will start with a number which is the second number of the previous term. Every term will start with a number which is the second number of the previous term. So that is also satisfying. Right, students? Now let us come to the answer. How will you find the answer? What is common difference? Common difference is 3 now. And now what is n? N is how many numbers are there in every term? In every term, we are taking two numbers. In every term, we are taking two numbers. So n will be equal to 2. Now, students, what is the formula? 1 divided by common difference into n plus 1. And students, along with it, now you can ignore all the terms. Just focus on this first term and the last term. So what do you have to do? यहां पर एक नंबर और ले लेना. यू हैव टू टेक वन मोर नंबर आफ्टर 35. सो एज यू कैन सी देयर इज अ डिफरेंस ऑफ 3. सो ऑब्वियसली आफ्टर 35 यू विल गेट अ 38. एंड स्टूडेंट, सिमिलरली यू हैव टू टेक वन मोर नंबर हियर ऑल्सो, बट यू हैव टू टेक दैट नंबर विच विल कम बिफोर 5. नाउ बिफोर 5 ऑब्वियसली यू विल गेट अ 2. सो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ यू हैव टू टेक डिफरेंस ऑफ दीज प्रोडक्ट्स. सो आंसर विल बी 32 × 35 × 38 minus 2 × 5 × 8. So that's it, guys. With this, you will get your answer. Okay, just to verify it, I am taking one more example for all of you. Please see here now. Let's say it is given. Let me start with a smaller number. Let's say 3 × 8 plus 8 × 13. Okay, and I'll take one more term. Let's say 13 × 18. Now, students, if let's say there are only 3 terms given, now we can solve this manually also. So if you solve this manually, what will you get? 8 × 3 is 24. 13 × 8 is 104. 13 × 18 is 180 and 54, that is 234. Now, students, if I add all these, what will I get? 234 plus 104, that is 338. 338 plus 24 is 362. So I know that answer should be 362. Okay. Answer should be 362. Now let us solve with the method which I have told you. First of all, what is common difference? Common difference is 5. How many numbers are there in every term? In every term, there are two numbers. So n is equal to 2. Now let us apply the formula. 1 upon common difference into n plus 1. So I'm directly writing 3. Now, students, along with it, first of all, our focus should be only on the first term and the last term. Abhi hum kya karenge? In the last term, students, you will take one more number. So if you take one more number, obviously that has to be 23. And now here also, student, you will take one more number, but the number which will come before 3. Now as a difference is of 5, so obviously the number before 3 will be minus of 2, will be minus of 2. And now students, we have to take difference of these two. We have to take difference of these two products. So finally, we'll be getting 23 into 18 into 13 minus of minus 2 into 3 into 8. So that will become plus 2 into 3 into 8. 2 into 3 into 8. Now students, let us solve this quickly. It won't take much time. 18 into 13. Students, 18 into 13, you can solve. That comes out to be 180 plus 54. That is 234. Now 234 into 23. If you solve it, 3 into 234 is 102. 702 you'll get. And 234 into 2 is 468. So you'll get a 2, you'll get a 8, 7, 6, 13, 1, 3, 5, 3, 8, 2. 5, 3, 8, 2 guys we are getting. So 1 by 15 and we are getting 5, 3, 8, 2 plus 8 into 3 into 2. Now 8 into 3 into 2 is 48. So students, from here, if we add this, we'll get 82 plus 48 is 130. So we'll get 5430. 5430. Now students, if you divide it by 15, just see what is the answer. 15 into 3 is 45. I'll get remainder 9, 93. 15 into 6 is 90 and we'll get a 30. So 15 into 2 is 30. So students, yes, 362 is the answer which we were getting as well. So students, a very important question. I hope all of you have understood this shortcut very well. I don't think you should have any difficulty. If any doubt, you can post it in the group itself. Okay, students. Yeah, thank you, everyone.